Morning all, I am Preeti, DL in Chemistry from TTWRDC Mulugu. As a part of video lecture, today we'll discuss about chemical kinetics. So before going to the topic chemical kinetics, as you know, what is mean by chemical reaction? So in a chemical reaction, reactants are converted into products. Okay, for a chemical reaction, two things are important. One is whether a reaction takes place spontaneously or not. Second thing, if the reaction occurs, at what rate the reaction takes place. So what is the first thing? Whether a reaction it takes place spontaneously or not. That means whether a reaction it takes place or not. Second thing, if a reaction takes place, at what rate? Rate means speed. At what speed the reaction takes place. So these two things are important for a chemical reaction. So first thing, it was explained by thermodynamics. So thermodynamics, it deals with the spontaneity of a reaction. Thermodynamics, it explains whether a chemical reaction takes place or not. Or it also tells in which direction a chemical reaction takes place. So if delta G means that is Gibbs free energy. If Gibbs free energy is negative, then such a reaction, it is a spontaneous reaction. So first thing, it was explained by thermodynamics. Second thing, if a reaction occurs, at what speed the reaction takes place. This was explained by chemical kinetics. So chemical kinetics, it explains about the speed of a reaction. So now we will see what is chemical kinetics. See, this is the definition of chemical kinetics. So what is that? Chemical kinetics, it is a branch of physical chemistry which deals with the rate of a reaction and its mechanism. Means chemical kinetics, it tells about the speed of a reaction and its mechanism. Not only speed of a reaction, it tells how experimental conditions influence the speed of a reaction. How the conditions, for example, if you take temperature. How does the temperature, it influence the speed of a reaction? It was explained in chemical kinetics. So this is the definition of chemical kinetics. So chemical kinetics, it tells about the speed or rate of a reaction. See, normally, if you consider a chemical reaction, there are three types of chemical reactions. First one, it is a fast or instantaneous reactions. Next one, reaction with measurable rates. And third one, it is very slow reactions. So chemical reactions are classified into three categories. So first one, it is fast or instantaneous reactions. The name itself indicates. So these chemical reactions, it takes place very fastly. For this, you can take example of ionic reactions. Most of the ionic reactions, they come under fast or instantaneous reactions. Here I have taken an example that is silver nitrate. See, if you add a sodium chloride solution to the silver nitrate solution, there is a formation of white precipitate immediately. That white precipitate is AgCl, silver chloride. See, I have written the equation. Silver nitrate, that is AgNO3, when it is treated with NaCl, there is a formation of white precipitate AgCl. So this reaction, it takes place very fastly. Within seconds, there is a formation of white precipitate. So why does this reaction takes place very fastly? Because in case of ionic reactions, there is a formation of ions. As you know, silver nitrate, it splits or it forms ions as Ag plus and NO3 minus, right? And NaCl also, it splits as Na plus and Cl minus, okay? Now this Ag plus, since it is a positive charge, it moves towards Cl minus, that is negatively charged chloride ions. So that's why there is a formation of AgCl. Since there is a formation of ions, these reactions, they takes place very fastly. These reactions, it takes place very fastly. Next, second one here, these are the reactions which takes place moderately. Reactions which takes place moderately. So for example, for this type of reactions is most of the reactions occurring between covalent substances. Most of the reactions occurring between the covalent substances belongs to second category, that is the rate or the speed of a reaction is moderate. For example, you can take hydrolysis of esters. Hydrolysis of esters. See, I have taken ester, that is CH3COOC2H5. That means ethyl acetate. I have taken ethyl acetate. Ethyl acetate, it undergoes hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means it is reacted with water in the presence of acid. In the presence of acid, that is H+ ion. So when esters, it undergoes hydrolysis, there is a formation of alcohol and carboxylic acid. You have to remember, when esters, they undergo hydrolysis, there is a formation of alcohol, that there is a formation of alcohol and carboxylic acids. So here, that's why there is a formation of C2H5OH, that is ethyl alcohol, and CH3COOH, that is acetic acid. So this reaction, it comes under moderate reaction, because in this reaction there is a breaking of covalent bond and formation of new bonds takes place. That's why these reactions, they takes place moderately. For this type of reactions, we can measure the speed of a reactions. So by using some experimental conditions, we can know the speed of a reaction, that is rate of a reaction. So that's why the heading is reaction with measurable rates. Measurable rates means we can find out the rate of a reaction, or we can know the speed of a reaction. Next, third one, it is a very slow reactions. Third one, it is very slow reactions. So some reactions, they takes place very slowly. For example, you can take rusting of iron. See here, I have taken this iron. This iron, iron, within 5 days or 6 days, the surface of the iron, it becomes rust. Why? See here, the surface of the iron, which is exposed to the air, it reacts with moist oxygen. This surface of the iron, it reacts with moist oxygen. So due to the reaction with moist oxygen, this iron, it converts into hydrated ferric oxide. That hydrated ferric oxide, it is nothing but rust. So rust, it is hydrated ferric oxide. So now this reaction, it takes place very slowly. Almost it takes 4 to 5 days. So this type of reactions, they comes under very slow reactions. So for such reactions, we can't find out a speed of a reaction, or we can't know the rate of a reaction by using experimental conditions. So these are the three chemical reactions. What are those? First one, it is fast or instantaneous reactions. Most of the ionic reactions comes under this category. Second one, reactions with measurable rate, means the speed of the reaction is moderately. That means we can find out the rate of a reaction. Third one, it is very slow reaction. For this very slow reactions, we can't find out rate of a reaction. So now we'll see the definition of rate of a reaction. What is mean by rate of a reaction? As we discussed, chemical kinetics, it explains about the rate of a reaction. What does this rate indicates? See here, rate indicates speed. Rate indicates speed, okay? Speed of a reaction. So what is the definition of speed of a reaction? As you know, how to find out the speed of an automobile? You know the formula how to find out speed of an automobile. See, we know that speed equals to distance traveled by automobile by time. This is the formula which is used to find out speed of an automobile. Since we are considering a chemical reaction, we can't take this distance, right? Then what you have to take? We have to take change in concentration of reactant or product. You have to take a change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. So this is the definition of a rate of a reaction. So this is the definition. What is that definition? Change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. So this is the definition. What does it mean? Change in concentration of reactant or product. What does it indicate? See here, I'm giving one example for that. See here. See this one. I have considered a chemical reaction, that is A converts to B, where A is reactant and B is product. In a beaker, I have taken reactants whose concentration is, let it be 1.00 mole, right? This is the concentration of A. See here, this is the initial concentration. Initial concentration means here at t equals to 0 seconds. See, time t equals to 0 seconds. That means the chemical reaction is not started yet. Since the chemical reaction it is not started, at this time, that is t equals to 0 seconds, we have only reactants. There are no products. Okay. So if you observe this one, as the time passes, what happens to the concentration of reactants? As the time passes, these reactants, they are converts into products. Reactants are converting into products. See, I have considered at 20 seconds. After 20 seconds, if you observe the second beaker, in this second beaker, we can see reactants as well as products. We can see reactants as well as products, because some of the reactant molecules, they are converted into products. Okay. So at 20 seconds, the concentration of a reactant, it is taken as 0.54 mole. Concentration of reactant is taken as 0.54 mole, and the concentration of product, it is taken as 0.46 mole. See here, initially there are no products, but after some time there are products, right? Next, considered at 40 seconds. So as the time passes, means you are increasing the time. As the time passes, now the concentration of A is 0.30 and the concentration of product is 0.70. If you observe this one, see here, initially there are only reactants, okay? After 40 seconds, there is a presence of reactants as well as products, means there is a change in concentration of reactant and product, okay? There is a change in concentration of reactant and product with respect to time, right? Means there is a change in concentration of reactant as well as product with respect to time, okay? This change, it is considered as rate of a reaction. That change, it is considered as rate of a reaction. See the definition. What is the definition? Rate of a reaction, it is change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. Okay, this is the definition of a rate of a reaction. This definition, it is also written in two more ways. See here, if you observe the concentration of a reactant A at t equals to 0 seconds, what is the concentration? 1. At 20 seconds, what is the concentration? 0.54. What happens to the concentration? Here, the concentration of reactants decreases, right? Why the concentration of reactants decreases? Because these reactants, they are converting into products. Reactants are converting into products. See here, at 40 seconds, again, the concentration of reactants decreases, means as the time passes, the concentration of reactants decreases because these reactants are converting into products. You have to remember this one. There is a decrease in concentration of reactants. Next, coming to products. Initially, there are no products, right? As the time passes, this is the concentration of products, that is 0.46. At 40 seconds, 0.70. See here, what happens to the concentration of products? Here, the concentration of products increases. Why it is increasing? Because reactants are converting into products. Okay, means from this we can say that concentration of reactants decreases as the time passes, and the concentration of products increases with respect to time. Okay, see here. Two more representations of rate of a reaction. So that's why if you want to write rate of a reaction particularly with respect to reactants, rate equals to, I can write like this. What is that? Decrease in concentration of reactant by time. This is with respect to reactants. If you want to write with respect to product, it is a increase in concentration of product per unit time. Okay, so these are the definitions of rate of a reaction. So what are the definitions of a rate of a reaction? You can say it as a change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. Or if you want to say with respect to reactants only, the definition is a decrease in concentration of reactant per unit time. Or if you want to indicate only products, it is increase in concentration of product per unit time. Okay. Now we will see what are the units for rate of a reaction. Rate of a reaction, it is represent units. Here in numerator we have concentration, right? In numerator we have concentration. So what are the units for concentration? Units for concentration is mole liter inverse, as you know. Mole liter inverse by units for time, it is second, right? So now the units for rate of a reaction is mole liter inverse, second inverse, right? So what are the units? What are the units for rate of a reaction? It is mole per liter second, or you can say mole liter inverse, second inverse, right? So this is the definition of rate of a reaction. Okay, next, now we'll see the graphical representation of rate of a reaction. See here, if you observe this graph, on x-axis you have to take time. Okay, on x-axis you have to take time. Graphical representation of rate of a reaction. Okay, on y-axis you have to take concentration. On y-axis you have to take concentration. See here, first consider reactants. As you know, initially means at time t equals to 0. This is time t equals to 0. At t equals to 0, there is a presence of only reactants. So that's why this point, it is the concentration of reactants at time t equals to 0. Okay, means at initial time there is a presence of only reactants, products are not there, right? So what happens to the concentration of reactants as the time passes? The concentration of reactants decreases, right? So that's why the graph will be, as the time increases, the concentration of reactants, it slowly decreases. The concentration of reactants decreases. Okay, that's why you have to draw a downward curve. Next, if you consider products, initially there are no products, means at time t equals to 0 there are no products. So that's why the concentration of product is 0. See here, there are no products. Okay, as the time passes, what happens? What happens to the concentration of products? Since the reactants are converting into products, there is an increase in concentration of products. So that's why you have to draw a upward curve. Okay, so this is the graphical representation of rate of a reaction. You have to represent like this. Okay, next. Again we will see the graphical representation. To write the mathematical expression for rate of a reaction, how to write the mathematical expression for rate of a reaction? See here. So this is the graphical representation of a rate of a reaction when you consider only reactants. In our previous slide, now we have seen that. This is the graph for reactants, and this is the graph for products. What happens to the reactants? You will get a downward curve. For products, you will get an upward curve, right? See here. Now you have to consider only products. Okay, now you have to consider only. Sorry, first you have to consider only reactants. Now I am telling how to write the mathematical expression for rate of a reaction. How to write mathematical expression for rate of a reaction. So for that I am considering the graph with respect to reactants. So as you know, this will be the graph. The graph will be downward, right? See here. In this graph, I am considering a particular time. First I am considering at T1 time. Okay. At T1 time, This is the concentration of reactants at T1 time. Here it is represented as R1. Okay. Next, at T2 time, this will be the concentration of reactant, that is R2. Okay. So there is a change in concentration, right? So this change in concentration with respect to time, it is considered as rate of a reaction, right? So now this slope, as you know, slope, how to find out? That is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this slope, it indicates the rate of a reaction. See here. How to write? You have to write like this. At y2 minus y1. y2 terms means you have to consider concentration of reactants. x1 term means you have to consider time. Okay. See here. I am writing like this. Concentration of reactant, that is R2. Concentration, it is represented by using square brackets, as you know. Okay. Minus concentration of reactants, that is R1 at T1 time, by T2 minus T1. Okay. So here, see here, this is a change in concentration, right? Simply it can be written as delta change in concentration of, it is reactant, so that's why you have to take it as delta concentration of reactants by, there is also change in time, so that's why you have to take delta T. So since you have to write here minus, you have to write a minus before this expression. Okay, so this is the representation of rate of a reaction, mathematical representation of rate of a reaction. See here, delta indicates change. Okay, change in concentration of reactant by change with time. Okay, in front of this I have written minus. What does it indicates? Remember, minus, it indicates whether there is increase or decrease in concentration. Minus particularly, it indicates decrease in concentration. Plus indicates a increase in concentration. Okay, no? Minus, it indicates decrease in concentration of reactant. So this is the representation of rate of a reaction. So how to represent rate of a reaction? Rate equals to, you can write like this, or simply you can write minus with respect to reactants, minus delta concentration of reactant by delta T. Okay, this one, it is also called average rate of a reaction. For finite for small changes, this formula, it is written as rate equals to, in place of delta, you can write, for small changes, you can write D concentration of R by dT. Okay. This is the mathematical representation of rate of a reaction. So what is that mathematical representation? Rate equals to minus dR by dT. Minus indicates decrease in concentration of reactants. Next. This is with respect to reactants. Okay. Now we'll see with respect to products what happens. See here. Same. On x axis you have to take time. On y axis you have to take concentration. As you know, this is the graph for product, right? You have to consider two particular times. I'm considering at T1 time. At T1 time, this is the concentration of product. Let it be considered as P1. At T1 time, it is P1. Next, at T2 time, the concentration of product, it is considered as P2. Okay. Now, the slope, it indicates rate of a reaction. That is, rate of a reaction equals to concentration of P2 minus concentration of P1 by T2 minus T1. Okay. So, this one, it can be written as R equals to concentration of P2 minus P1, means there is a change in concentration of product. P2 indicates, here it is the concentration of product at the T2 time, right? P1 indicates it is the concentration of product at T1 time. So this one, it can be written as delta concentration of product by delta T. Okay. So how to write? Rate equals to, with respect to products, it can be written as delta concentration of P by delta T. In front of this, you have to write a positive sign. In case of reactants, we have written negative sign. Okay, negative sign, it indicates decrease in concentration. What is positive indicates? Positive, it indicates increase in concentration. As you know, concentration of products, they are increasing. So that's why you have to write positive sign. For infinite changes or for small changes, it can be written as rate equals to plus d concentration of p by dt. Okay, so this is the formula which is used to write, this is the mathematical expression to write rate of a reaction. So these are the two diagrams. So see, same, this is with respect to reactants, this one is with respect to products. Okay, next, as I explained this one in previous, in terms of reactants, rate equals to, you can write R2 minus R1 by T2 minus T1, or it is taken as dr by dt. Okay, in terms of products, you can consider P2 minus P1 by T2 minus T1, or it is represented as dp by dt. And see, one more thing here, rate equals to rate of a reaction with respect to reactants, each and every reactant and each and every product, it should be equal, they are equal. Okay, so this is the mathematical representation of rate of a reaction. Now we will see some examples. See here, I have taken one example, that is N2O5, a dinitrogen pentoxide. It gives rise to NO2 plus half O2. For this, I want to write, I want to represent rate of a reaction. Since N2O5, it is a reactant, and NO2 and O2, they are products. Okay, if you want to write with respect to reactants, how to write? Since we are writing with respect to reactants, you have to keep minus d of concentration of N2O5 by dt, right? It is equals to, next you have to write products. Here, what is the product? NO2. Since it is a product, you have to write a sign, that is plus. Okay, you have to write plus. Here, see here, how many moles are there? 2 moles are there. Since we have to consider only for 1 mole, so that's why for 1 mole you have to consider 2, it is written as 1 by 2. Suppose if it is 3, you have to write it as 1 by 3. Suppose it is 4, then you have to write it as 1 by 4. So plus 1 by 2 d of NO2 by dt. Okay, and again this one, it is equals to, again this one, it is equals to oxygen. Half means you can write 2 d of concentration of oxygen by dt. Okay, so this is the mathematical expression which is used to write rate of a reaction. And now we will take this one, it indicates here, for 1 mole of decomposition of N2O5, for 1 mole of decomposition of N2O5, 2 moles of NO2 and half mole of O2 will be formed. Half mole of O2 is formed. Okay, now we will take one more example. So here I have taken one more example, that is when SO2, it is treated with O2, gives rise to SO3. How to write rate of a reaction? See here, what are the reactants? One is SO2, another one is oxygen. So since rate equals to, you can write minus, since it is a reactant, so that's why you have to write minus. How many number of moles here? 2. That means you have to write 1 by 2 d concentration of SO2 by dt. Okay, now this one, it is equals to, see here, minus this one, it is, this one, it is equals to, observe this one, it is equals to, now we have to write with respect to oxygen. Since it is a reactant, you have to write minus d concentration of O2 by dt. Okay, it is equals to, now you have to write with respect to product, you can write plus, or no need of writing plus. Okay, then here it is 2 moles, that's why you have to write 1 by 2 d concentration of SO3 by dt. So this is one more example to represent rate of a reaction. This indicates if 0.5 moles of SO2 is consumed in the reaction, the amount of what you consumed is 0.25 moles. For 0.5 moles of SO2, we require how much amount of oxygen we require? 0.25 moles of oxygen is required. So this is about mathematical representation of rate of a reaction. So now we will see what is mean by rate law or rate constant. See here, before going to the the definition of rate law. So now we'll see what is mean by rate law. Or rate law, it is also considered as a rate equation, not rate constant. Here it is also considered as rate equation. Okay. Before going to the definition, here I have drawn a table. Observe this table. This table, it indicates the effect of concentration on rate of a reaction. That means what happens to the rate of a reaction if you change the concentration of reactants. So that one it is indicated by this table. See here, I have considered a chemical reaction, that is hydrogen. When it is reacted with nitric oxide, there is a formation of nitrogen and H2O. So here, how many reactants are there? Two reactants are there. One is hydrogen, another one is NO. So in third column, we have to take rate of a reaction. You have to consider rate of a reaction. So observe this one. Here the concentration of reactant hydrogen, it is taken as 1, and NO it is taken as 1. Then the rate of a reaction is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4 mole liter inverse second inverse. Okay. In second case, here we are keeping the concentration of hydrogen constant. We are not changing the concentration of hydrogen. We are changing the concentration of NO2. We are changing the concentration of NO2. What we are doing? We are doubling the concentration of NO. We are doubling the concentration of NO. Means we are increasing two times. Then what happens to the rate of a reaction? What happens to the rate of a reaction? Observe this one. Since you are doubling the concentration of nitric oxide, what happens to the rate of a reaction? Initially at concentration 1, here the rate is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4. If the concentration of NO is doubled, that is 2, then the rate of a reaction is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Means here the rate of a reaction is also increased. How many times it increased? 4 times. Means if you double, it is increased for 4 times. Okay, remember this one. Next case here, you are not changing the concentration of nitric oxide. Means here in next case, you are keeping the concentration of nitric oxide constant. Here you have to change the concentration of hydrogen. Okay, you are changing the concentration of hydrogen. Now we'll see what happens. See here, if you observe this one, what happens here? The concentration, it is 1, and here you are doubling the concentration. Okay, 2. At 1, if the concentration is 1, what is the rate of a reaction? It is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Here we are increasing the concentration for 2 times. If you increase for 2 times, what happens to the rate of a reaction? See here, it is 4 to 8. 8 means it is also increased 2 times. Okay, remember this one. Means here, in first case, we kept a concentration of hydrogen constant and we doubled the concentration of nitric oxide. So what happens? The rate of a reaction, it is increased by 4 times. Okay. See, we are keeping a hydrogen constant. First case, hydrogen constant, and we have doubled the concentration of NO. NO concentration is increased by 2 times. So what happens to the rate? Rate, it is increased by 4 times. Okay. In next case, we kept a NO constant and we changed the concentration of hydrogen. We have doubled the concentration of hydrogen. Then what happens to the rate here? the rate also doubled or it increased by 2 times. So you have to remember this one. So from this we can say that rate of a reaction, see here in next slide, from the above experiment we can say that, see here, if you double the concentration of NO, what happens to the rate? It increased by 4 times, means 1, 2. That means here from this we can say that rate of a reaction is directly proportional to concentration of NO to the power of, you can write, 2. Okay, similarly rate is directly proportional to concentration of hydrogen. See here, if you double the concentration of hydrogen, what happens to the rate? Rate also doubled. Okay, 2 to 1, 1 means here you can write it as rate is directly proportional to concentration of hydrogen to the power of n. You can write to the power of n. Okay, to the power of 1. Okay, this indicates, from this we can say, if you double the concentration of nitric oxide, the rate of a reaction, it is increased by 4 times. From this we can say, if you double the concentration of hydrogen, the rate is increased for 2 times. Means rate of a reaction, it depends upon the concentration of reactants. Now the rate law, it can be written as, you can write like this, see here. The rate is directly proportional to NO, as well as it is directly proportional to hydrogen. Concentration of NO and concentration of hydrogen. So that's why combinedly we can write it as rate is directly proportional to concentration of NO to the power of 2 into concentration of hydrogen. So this expression, it is considered as rate law. This expression So this expression, it is considered as rate law. So rate is directly proportional to concentration of NO to the power of 2 into concentration of hydrogen. Here NO and hydrogen, they comes under reactants, right? So this relation, it is considered as rate law. Means rate law, it is a mathematical expression. Rate law, it is a rate equation or rate law. It is a mathematical expression which gives a relation between rate of a reaction. It gives a relation between rate of a reaction and concentration of reactants. That mathematical expression, it is considered as rate law or rate equation. And remember, this rate law, it can be derived from experimental studies only. See here, here we have written NO to the power of 2, and here nothing is there, means hydrogen to the power of 1. These values we can know experimentally, okay? Simply by observing the chemical equation, we can't write these values. Remember this point. These values, it can be known experimentally, okay? So this is the definition of rate law. So now we'll see the definition. So what is the definition of rate law? Which is also called rate equation. Rate law, it is defined as the mathematical relation between rate of a reaction and concentration of reactants. Then it is considered as a rate law or rate equation. So here I have considered equation xA plus yB gives rise to C, where x and y, they are stoichiometric coefficients, and a, b are reactants, and c is products. So for this equation, if you want to write a rate law, you have to write like this. How to write a rate of a reaction, which is represented as small r, is directly proportional to concentration of a to the power of x into concentration of b to the power of y. And remember, to remove this proportionality, you have to keep a constant. This constant, it is represented by using small k. It is represented by using a letter k. So this K it indicates rate constant. Here K it is called rate constant. So now this equation, it is considered as rate equation or rate law. And remember one more point here, x and y, these are not stoichiometric coefficients. X and y, in some chemical reactions only it is equal to stoichiometric coefficient. So x and y, these are may or may not be equal to stoichiometric coefficient. X and y, it can be determined experimentally. Okay, so this is the definition of rate law or rate equation. So what is the definition? Rate law, here it is the mathematical representation. It is a rate law indicates, it is a mathematical relation between rate of a reaction and concentration of reactants. And to remove this proportionality, how the relation will be directly proportional? Remember, rate of a reaction is directly proportional to concentration of the reactants. Okay, to remove this proportionality, how to write a constant that is considered as rate constant? So see here, R equals to K into A and B, where K is rate constant. A and B, these are the concentration of reactants, A to the power of X, B to the power of Y. Okay, now we'll see what is the definition of rate constant. What does rate constant indicate? See here, consider this equation. I'm considering this equation, that is R equals to K into concentration of A into concentration of B. Okay, see here, I'm considering if concentration of reactant A is 1 molar concentration. Similarly, I'm considering the concentration of B is also 1 molar concentration. Now we have to substitute this equation. If you substitute these values, in this equation, what is that equation? R equals to K into concentration of A into concentration of B. So R equals to K into concentration of A, it is taken as 1 into 1. So what happens? R equals to K. Okay, R equals to K. Now you got R equals to K. R means rate of a reaction, K means rate constant. See here, rate constant, it is equals to rate of a reaction. But what is the condition? When the concentration of reactants, they are taken as unit concentration. When the concentration of reactants, they are taken as unit concentration. So rate constant, it is defined as rate constant, it is equals to rate of a reaction when concentration of each of the reactants, it is unity. Okay, R equals to K. When does it happens? When concentration of A equals to 1 and concentration of B equals to 1. So that's why the definition of rate constant is R equals to K. It is rate constant, it is defined as, it is equals to rate of a reaction when the concentration of each reactant, it is taken as unit concentration, then only R equals to K. So this is the definition of a rate constant. And one more thing here, the units of rate constant, it depends upon the order of a reaction. So what does order of a reaction indicates? Now we will see what is meant by order of a reaction. Order of a reaction. So order, what is meant by order of a reaction? So now I'll say what is meant by order of a reaction. See, if you observe the previous equation, rate law, this is rate law, right? The sum of the terms of the powers of the concentration of the reactants, they are considered as order of a reaction. So this is the definition of order of a reaction. So order, it is sum of the powers of concentration of reactants, it is considered as order of a reaction. So if you consider in a rate law, if you consider this rate law here, x and y, these are the powers of concentration of reactants. So if you add these powers, that is x plus y, this x plus y, it is considered as order of a reaction. Okay, the rate constant units, it depends upon the order of a reaction. So this is about a rate constant. So this is about chemical kinetics. So thank you.